You know our next guest from her role on Gossip Girl, and she's the lead singer of The Pretty Reckless. Give it up for one badass chick, Taylor Momsen, everybody! I like it. So this is the way you dress, right? This is how you like to dress.
Yes.
I love it. You look fantastic.
Well, thank you. As do you.
Thank you. Do I look all right?
I'm very fashionable.
Yeah?
Yes.
Do I look like I'm going to court to defend myself?
No. No, I like the purple adds a little bit of flair.
Cool. Thank you. Thank you. So everybody knows you from Gossip Girl, right?
Yes.
That's big facts. And they think that that's real life.
There is an element of that. I will say I'm not Jenny Humphrey, everyone. Yeah. I am a different person. It is a character I play on television.
Yes, but people, when they see you, what do they ask you? Like, what's happening in the show? Or is little Jay ever going to go back to Gossip Girl?
Well, the show's been very great. I mean, they've been very supportive of my music because I have this band, The Pretty Reckless.
Yeah.
And we just released our record yesterday. Debuted number 2 on iTunes, which
is awesome. There you go. I like that.
Number 1 on the rock charts. I'm very excited.
Really? That's hot.
Yeah, it's very unbelievable. We have the best fans.
Yes, and your tour starts in Los Angeles tomorrow, on
tomorrow.
Friday.
Tomorrow, yes, it does. Are you going to come?
You know what? I'm out of town.
You're out of town? Lame.
I'm playing golf in Pebble Beach, but I will go see you, I promise.
All right, you promise. Is everyone else going to come?
Yes. Friday? Where's the tour going?
It's Friday. It kicks off Friday at the El Rey. In LA here, and it goes all across North America, and I'm not exactly sure where it ends.
That's okay, but because you're in music, you don't have to really be sure.
I go day to day. It's very, very.
That's total rock
it's
star.
Very busy schedule.
That's total rock star. That's cool. Hey, so check this out. Here's the Pretty Reckless CD. It's called Light Me Up. Now there's a little girl on the cover.
Yes.
Is that little girl? Is that you?
it's not me, but it's based off a photo of me. That the concept came from. Actually, it's just kind of funny. There's a photo of me when I was 2 or 3, same haircut, and I'm sitting on a motorcycle, a little motorcycle with a leather jacket and Ray-Bans, and it was a kind of a photo that's been passed around in my family for a long time, so the idea of the record cover came from that.
When you were a little girl, what kind of music did you like?
Well, I grew up listening to a lot of vinyl. My dad's a big rock and roll fan, so, I mean, the first band I ever heard was the Beatles, and they're still my favorite.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And, you know, Zeppelin, The Who, Pink Floyd, AC/DC, a lot of the classics, and still do. And then I got into, you know, Rage and Soundgarden and Nirvana right. and stuff.
You know what's
older.
Funny when you say that? When you say the classics, I was in high school during the classics. Whoop! Yeah. Back in 1963.
I love the 60s.
No, they were great.
I mean, the song Factory Girl is actually about, I mean, it's about the 60s. I love the 60s.
All of those
Andy
bands,
Warhol,
yes.
Edie Sedgwick, it's got that feel to it. It's Factory Girl about, you know, the factory. Andy Warhol's factory.
All mentioned great, great bands. Also, let's see, in the album notes, I love this. You thank the haters yes. and Hustler.
Well, yes. Hustler. Shoes by Hustler, everyone. Larry Flynt, I think, is fantastic.
Yeah.
I love Larry Flynt. So I had to thank him.
You go shopping at Hustler for your everyday clothes?
For my stage shoes.
Yeah.
For the
What about lingerie? Do you go there and buy lingerie and stage?
Some lingerie, you know, you can find the tights, all the tights. There's a couple different stores, but Hustler is definitely the main one, and I had to thank him.
Okay,
I mean,
cool.
Larry
that's good.
Flynt's awesome. And, you know, the haters, like, they just keep you entertained, and that's what's written in the record.
Yes, you know what? The haters do keep you entertained.
They're the funniest because they, I mean, there are some vehement haters out there that really, really loathe you, and it's totally entertaining.
Now, when you get misquoted, it's always from people that don't like, I mean, it's never things you actually say. It's always misquotes.
I mean, the one thing about the press, I'm surprised how much they can get away with because it's so constantly misquoted. I mean, there was literally an article where the headline of the article misquoted the article. Like, literally.
Yeah.
I mean, it's I'm amazed because it's what I say, and then they take out words and make it sound like a negative statement, and
It inspires you.
I hope everyone knows that it's not actually real. You know, it's not exactly what I'm saying. Unless you're seeing me say it, I probably didn't.
Exactly. Thank you. Now, what does this say on your shoes right there?
Oh, it says tips.
Tips?
Yes.
All right. You're accepted.
It became a thing. We were on Warp Tour and last summer, and I had these shoes, and a fan asked to put money in them, and then it became this kind of joke through the whole tour that I'd put my shoe up on the merch booth because we'd meet fans and sign stuff every day after the show. And I have different currencies. I've got Canadian money, you know, European everything, and euros, everything filled up notes.
That's nice. Oh, that's cool.
It's a new pair of those, so they're nice and clean.
Yeah, yeah, but not a lot of people do that. Not a lot of people take time to go after and meet the fans and take pictures with them.
The fans are what make it. I mean, we have the best fans, and they're what allow us to do what we love.
Yeah. Let's talk about the paparazzi. The paparazzi, they give you trouble, right? They follow you everywhere.
They have an interesting job, yes. I mean, there have been some crazy times. They're dangerous. That's they are aggressive.
Now, we have a photo that you took of them chasing you. Let's show the picture. You can look at it right there, Taylor. What's going on there?
Oh, God. That's a cell phone picture from Paris. And that's just the people in the back of the car. That's taken from the car. They're chasing us from the show. And there's people on the sides and the front. But that's what you can see out of the back.
Yeah.
And we like to mess with them because it's just, we find it funny.
Yeah.
So we have, you know, we're taking pictures of them as they're taking pictures of us. We got chased in L.A. Not too long ago. And we thought, we had time to kill. So we thought it would be thoroughly entertaining just to waste their time. So we drove from the opposite end of L.A. to Venice Beach and drove around the same block 20 times in a circle.
Did they follow you?
And they followed us all around the circle 20 times, wasting their time, and then we lost them at a light, and they'd followed us for 2 hours and must have been so pissed that they didn't get a picture.
I mean, that's crazy shit. That's crazy shit!
But you gotta take it lightheartedly. I mean, everyone's got a job, you know? It's their job.
Okay, so you're on Gossip Girl. Now you're doing music very successfully, by the way, because of the success of the CD. But music was not your first job.
Music was not my first job, no. I started modeling when I was 2, and I did my first commercial at 3 for Shake and Bake.
Modeling at 2 and a commercial at 3. Let's take a look at the commercial. Check this out.
Oh, gosh.
This is how you make Shake and Bake. What? Shake it all crazy, then it's crunchy and ready to eat. I shook and Mom cooked.
Shake and Bake. Do you remember doing the commercial?
I remember I spit out a lot of chicken. That's all I remember.
All right, so when you're an actress, you would eat chicken, but now that you rock, and now that your CD's doing well, you can't eat a chicken, so we made some Shake and Bake bats.
Oh, my gosh.
Look at that.
That's great.
You can bite the head off a bat.
Is it actually chicken? That's the question.
That is not chicken. That might be a bat. Hey, when we come back, the Pretty Reckless will perform and Taylor will sing. We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Performing just tonight off their CD, Light Me Up. Give it up for the Pretty Reckless.
To hear what I say, start the car and take me home. It's just tonight. See straight, but I'm too numb to feel right now. And here I am, watching the clock that's ticking away my time. I'm too numb to feel right now. Just tonight, I will stay. I won't leave, and I'll lie and you'll believe. Just tonight, I'll see that it's all because of me. Just tonight, I'll stay, and we'll throw it all away. When the light hits your eyes, it's telling me I'm right. And you're fine, I'm through.
They're pretty reckless. Go see them on tour. They start this Friday at the El Rey in Los Angeles. Let me thank my guests, Brad Womack, Taylor Momsen, and the Pretty Reckless. You have just seen the baddest show on late night. Good night.